On this episode of Patrol Tactical, we review HIPERFIRE's newest product, the HiperTouch Enhanced Duty Trigger. Hello everyone, thanks for checking out this video. My name is Dave from Patrol Tactical, and we are excited to have a new product from HIPERFIRE in our hands, and that is the HiperTouch EDT. And EDT stands for, especially for Dave Tim.
I think it was something else.
No, it's EDT, that's my initials.
Enhanced duty trigger,
I think. Well, it says enhanced duty trigger, but that's kind of a coincidence. But anyway, well, okay. Technically, he is right. It is enhanced duty trigger, but I am really excited about this product. My background with HIPERFIRE goes back to last year when I first started talking to Terry Bender about their 24 line of triggers, the HiperTouch 24 3G in particular. I was really excited to get my hands on that trigger, and we ended up using it in the Holdra Xprete 2, which I was involved with that project, and I have thousands and thousands of rounds through those model triggers, and I have been really, really impressed. And when I was talking with Terry Bender, the owner and lead engineer for HIPERFIRE, I told him, I said, I really love the trigger for three gun, for competition shooting, for a special purpose rifle. They're all absolutely amazing triggers for those use. But for a patrol rifle, for a duty rifle, for maybe even a service rifle match or home defense, it was just a little too light, a little too crisp. Almost too high performance, if that sounds like something that you would actually complain about with a trigger. And I said, you know, for a duty rifle, I don't know if I would put it in a duty working patrol gun. And he actually agreed. And he said, you know, I actually have a trigger in the works that I think you'll be really excited about. And when it comes out, I'll get in touch with you and you can check it out. Well, that time has come with the EDT. And I got to tell you guys, bottom line up front, it is an amazing trigger. With an MSRP of $89, I'm blown away by how well this trigger works for a sub-$100 trigger. The reality is it performs better than several single-stage triggers that are more than that price, as of course the ones that are, you know, less than that price. But the enhanced duty trigger really, really does impress me. Now, in the industry, you know, I'm a big believer in giving disclosure. And as far as that goes, I want to tell you that I did receive this trigger from HIPERFIRE for review. So I didn't buy it, but if you think that that's going to change my opinion or make me biased in any way, I give you my word it's not true. If there's things I don't like about the trigger, we will talk about them. If there's things I don't appreciate about it or don't like, you will hear about it. I'm going to give you my honest and unbiased review. Let's talk about what comes in the package. First things first, you get some directions. And one of the things I really admire about HIPERFIRE is the directions that they include with all of their products are really well thought out. They have illustrations, diagrams, a parts list, the warranty information, contact information. They're really, really good instructions. You can tell that they're written by English-speaking Americans and not translated. And that's the other cool thing with HIPERFIRE is that all of their stuff is made in the United States by Americans. So what else is in the package is the parts. The parts are the hammer. And if you guys are familiar with the HiperTouch 24 series of triggers, you'll see some similarities in the hammer from that line of triggers to this line of triggers. We also have the trigger itself, disconnector, disconnector spring, pins, two hammer springs. The green will provide a 4.5 pound weight, and the red will provide a 5.5 pound trigger pull weight. And then they also include this drift pin, and this is actually a really great tool for installation of any trigger for that matter. It has a pointed end and a flat end, so you'll use this to install the trigger, which I'll show you guys here in a little bit. So just let's talk about the components before we dive into the installation. The hammer is obviously different from a traditional hammer. It doesn't have the hook, and you can tell it's purpose designed for this trigger, and it takes a lot of influence from the HiperTouch 24 series of triggers. It is very, very well machined. It looks good. I put some rounds through it obviously already just so I can know what we're talking about before we started this, but overall, it's really a clean, clean unit. All of the components are investment cast. They are machined and heat treated, and they're all, again, made in the United States. So the hammer looks like a nice piece here. It doesn't have any of the extra stuff that is not needed for this. It's not a full auto hammer, obviously. Now the trigger, I did notice some differences. And this is what I want to spend a little bit of time talking about. Again, investment cast, machined and heat treated, all in the USA. But you'll notice that the shape kind of between the two from a standard mil-spec trigger is a little different. The sear surface is different. So we're using that sear technology from the 24 series. We don't have quite the same face, but yet the engagement is still very impressive. Once we get everything together, the engagement of the sear surface is still good and safe. I didn't have any issues with dropping or impact tests or anything like that. But the shape, particularly towards the back and the bottom, is different. You'll notice it is ramped up compared to a standard mil-spec type trigger, where you can see how much bigger and more blocky it is. And when I was talking to Terry about this, this is part of the design, this ramping right here. And what that does is helps enhance the reliability of the trigger in case debris or a primer or a pebble or whatever gets in the lower receiver. And as you know, this pivots, something could get lodged in between the trigger and the floor of the lower receiver. And this provides more clearance for that gunk or debris, so it will not, you know, prohibit the operation of the trigger. So I was pretty impressed with that. That's a pretty cool addition to a trigger, and you can see a comparison here of the difference. The other thing I noticed was the skeletonized cuts in the trigger. Where the disconnector slot is right here, you can see that there's cuts, and there's not cuts on a standard mil-spec trigger. And again, that was part of the design. Now, at first I thought, well, maybe it's to lighten it or anything like that, but the reality is what he wanted was to virtually make this device almost self-cleaning. So if some crud or debris got in there, it would, in essence, work its way out. So again, it kind of acts as a, you know, a grate, if you will, to help material and things like that fall through it and not get in the way and bind up the trigger. So again, really impressive and truly trying to enhance that reliability of a duty trigger. So some engineering stuff I was really, really impressed with. So those are the components. Again, everything looks really, really good. Very impressed when I saw the package. You can tell that the components are quality components at that. Installation of the enhanced duty trigger is really simple. If you've installed a standard fire control group, it'll be right up your alley. In order to install it, you don't need to remove the safety selector. You just need a lower with the fire control group removed. If you have any questions on how to do that, we did make a separate video on removing the fire control group. A link will be in the description. The drift pin that's included with the EDT makes installation really easy. First, we're going to install the trigger, and the bow of the trigger will go through the hole in the lower receiver, and these legs of the trigger spring will rest on the floor of the lower receiver. So make sure that these don't go through the hole. So simply insert the trigger like that. Take your disconnector spring, and you'll notice the disconnector spring, it has a coned edge, or a larger edge, a flange to it, that will go into the trigger. The smaller side will be on the top. So simply place the large end down into the circle cutout of the trigger as shown. Then we can take our disconnector, and our disconnector has a cutout here. That cutout goes right on top of the spring, and then the hole there will line up where the pin will go through on the trigger. So we're simply going to place the disconnector, go ahead and press that in place. Make sure that that cutout goes right over the disconnector spring, and it will kind of rock back and forth a little bit, and I know it will be a little awkward at first, but then we're just going to press down on the disconnector, and we're going to push the drift pin through. And again, that pointed part of the drift pin makes this a lot easier. And we're just going to push this through, and then we will take one of the pins provided, and we'll use this side, and we'll go right against the flat edge of the drift pin, and we'll just follow that, and we'll push through. The drift pin will come out, and we're just going to follow that drift pin out with this pin, installing it just like that. So really easy with that drift pin. We're just going to do a quick check. We're going to make sure that the trigger pivots. Make sure the disconnector moves just like so. You can actually feel it move against the spring. If something is binding or not pivoting, something is wrong. You'll have to take it out and start over. Now the hammer, you do need to install a hammer spring. I'm gonna install the green hammer spring, which will give a 4.5 pound trigger weight. And there is a right and a wrong way to install a hammer spring. So what I like to do, the easiest way that I show guys, is set the hammer down, so as if it's gonna be striking like this, and then the hammer spring goes like this. So these coils will go around these portions here and here. This tab of the hammer spring will go right here, and then the legs go on the bottom. Make sure you have it so the legs are on the bottom going down like that. If it's flipped over like this, when you're looking at it all together, that's incorrect and it will not have sufficient striking energy. It will be taking away energy. So to install it, we simply put it over the top like that. Kind of give it a bend and a twist, a bend and a twist. And now the hammer spring is on just like that. And again, you'll see that the legs are right on the bottom. When we install the hammer, we're going to take the two legs and we're going to go behind the trigger pin and then we'll go forward. We need those legs of the hammer spring to engage the pin, the trigger pin. So we'll pretend if this was the trigger pin, they'll actually engage like that. And you can see this small cutout, that one of the legs of the trigger pin will ride like that, keeping that trigger pin in place. So again, start from behind and go forward. Take your drift pin, push down and twist the hammer. And hopefully you guys can see that on camera. We're gonna kind of twist the hammer back as we're pushing down. We're gonna make sure the hole lines up and just get that drift pin in and started. Just like that is enough. Then we'll come back down, position, and again, push that drift pin through. We're gonna follow that drift pin with a pin. And it's important to note there are two cutouts, a center notch and an outer notch. And then there's another side that does not have a notch. We want to use this side to go through. Otherwise, we'd have to push through this notch and then get to this one, whereas we can push with this one and just get right to the center notch. So we're just going to follow the drift pin with a pin and push straight through until it locks right into place just like that. The drift pin will fall out. That's all right. So now we have everything all installed. So now let's head to the range. I'll get you some footage that we put about 300 plus rounds through this trigger with different types of ammo and it performed flawlessly. As you can see from our range footage, the trigger performed flawlessly, and it was actually very impressive to shoot. The feel of the trigger is really, really good. There is a little bit of take up or creep till you get to the wall that breaks the trigger. And again, it's very enjoyable. It's a very, very positive experience, especially for a duty trigger. I installed the trigger in my Korstog VAR and absolutely impressed with the performance of the trigger. Now, keep in mind, if you're a three gunner, this is still a very viable option. But if you're looking for an ultra light, super crisp, minimal travel, you know, you're probably better served with the 24 series. I really love the 24 3G, but for a working gun, for a home defense gun, for a tactical match gun, for service rifle, where you have a minimum trigger pull weight, This is awesome. And what's great about it is the inclusion of the two different trigger springs for the 4.5 and 5.5 pound weights can really meet a lot of the requirements that some department policies may have for personally owned patrol rifles. Some of them may dictate it must have a 4 pound, must have a 5 pound, whatever it might be. But this trigger really has impressed me. It is crisp, it breaks how it should, it has a very, very distinct positive reset, and there's virtually no over travel. So when the trigger breaks, again, there's virtually no over travel. The reset is distinct, it's audible, you can feel it, you're already at that wall. If we slowly, slowly press the trigger back, you can see there is some movement, but again, virtually no over travel. So the point to where it breaks, there's really not any more distance that we need to go. The reset is great, no issues with the reset. It's not mushy at all. There's no grit, there's no grinding feeling like at some of the triggers, and plus the pull weight is very, very attractive. I am, again, very, very impressed with the trigger. It feels good. When you wanna get a nice, smooth trigger press, you have no issues doing so with this trigger. It doesn't prohibit you. Some of the mil-spec triggers out there, I've seen them weigh anywhere from 6 to 12 pounds. So they're really all over. Plus some of them have horrible grit. It actually just feels like there's almost gravel and it's just a rough break that is just ugly. That's the biggest complaint I get with mil-spec triggers from students. And this, man, again, what a nice, nice trigger this is. Let's take the gauge to the trigger and see what the actual weights are. Yeah, 4, 6.8 ounces. 4 pounds, 9 ounces. So again, right at that, right around that 4.5 pound trigger pull weight. So really, really impressive. All right, I just threw the red spring in, which will give about a 5.5 pound trigger pull weight. 5 pounds, 9 ounces, right there. 5 pounds, 8 ounces, right on the money. So that's pretty accurate. And this, I'll tell you guys, is not the best gauge. It's a little finicky sometimes, so. I believe the specs when they say 4.5 and 5.5 pounds respectively. I think that's very, very accurate. Especially it feels, you know, really good to that, as you know, to those specs as well. The other cool thing that I liked about this design, and I don't have the long-term experience myself to verify this, but Terry says that as the springs wear, it will still maintain those trigger weights. So as the gun breaks in, or as the trigger breaks in from prolonged use, you will still get those minimum weights, which is important for a duty rifle that has department policy or service rifle matches. The springs are proprietary. A lot of trigger companies use a lighter weight spring to achieve a better trigger pull, and he actually is using a heavier trigger pull weight. So you have a faster lockup time, you have more hammer strike force, and you have that good performance. So if you're looking for an upgrade from a mil-spec type fire control group, this to me is a no-brainer, and especially for the price. For $89 MSRP, street price may be a little bit lower depending on the dealer. There is a minimum advertised price, I know, but MSRP of 89 bucks, I am really, really impressed. Again, I've shot a lot of triggers, mil-spec improvement triggers or replacement triggers, and when it comes to duty, I actually prefer a single stage trigger, although I really like Geissele's two stage triggers. They're a nice trigger. But for me, I just really like a nice single stage trigger. And what I'm getting with this is that nice single stage trigger. So all in all, I really like it. I do highly recommend it. Is there anything I don't like about the trigger? Number one, I don't like that I'm gonna have to buy probably a few of them for different rifles. But kidding aside, the only complaint I had was because of the skeletonized cut of the trigger. This is a mil-spec trigger that doesn't have all the cuts and things like that. But the cuts of that one, I did notice the disconnector spring can kind of wave or wobble a little bit during installation. And it's not really a pain, as just a minor annoyance. So if there was one thing I didn't like, it would probably be that as you're installing that disconnector, that spring can flop in that track a little bit. Doesn't make installation difficult by any means, but it is something I noticed. Other than that, I have no complaints with the trigger. For the performance, the price, it's probably the best bang for the buck out on the market right now. For more information, check out their webpage, hiperfire.com. I'll put a link in the description below. But I appreciate you watching. I know this was a long video, but again, when I do my reviews, I want to make sure we get a lot of good information. information out there for you so you are an informed consumer. You know what you're getting and you know what my thoughts are on it. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Leave your comments below. Check us out on Facebook, facebook.com/patroltactical. We'd love to have you like us there. Thank you very much for watching. I do sincerely appreciate it. Whenever you shoot, make sure you shoot safe and have a great day.